Good afternoon and good evening, distinguished scholars, colleagues, participants, delegates, speakers and moderators at the different location on the globe of the world. First of all, I wish like to introduce my sincere thanks to the conference committee and conference management to provide me a facility to deliver my talk at this important conference. Let me inform you that this is a multidisciplinary conference, and I am sure you agree with me that every scientist is not familiar with every subject of the science. Therefore, at the beginning of my talk, I will introduce the basic terms and definition related to the shape reversibility and shape memory, all this. And after that, I will introduce the experimental results performed on two coupled with shape memory alloys. Shape memory alloys takes place a class of advanced smart materials exhibiting a peculiar property called shape memory effect. This phenomenon is initiated with thermomechanical processes on cooling and deformation and performed thermally in a temperature interval on heating and cooling, which the shape of the material cycle between original and deformed shape in reversible way. Therefore, this behavior can be called thermoelasticity. This is plastic deformation due to the soft character of the material in the low temperature condition. Deformation energy is stored in the material and released on heating by recovering the original shape. Shape memory alloys exhibit another property called superelasticity, which is performed with mechanical stretching and releasing the material in elasticity limit at constant temperature in the current phase region. And this behavior can be called mechanical memory either. These alloys are functional materials with these properties and used in many fields from biomedical application to the building and industry against the seismic effect. Shape memory effect is characterized by the recoverability of two certain shapes of material in reversible way in the different conditions. This is the basic mechanism of shape memory effect and superelasticity. For the shape memory effect, materials are deformed in the low temperature condition and upon releasing, material keeps the deformed shape due to the plastic deformation. After that, on heating, recover the original shape and shape of the material cycle between deformed and original shape on cooling and heating in reversible way. For the superelasticity, materials are stressed in elasticity limit in the parent region and upon releasing, record the original shape by exhibiting ordinary elastic material behavior. Shape memory effect is result of the structural transformations, thermal and stress-induced materials transformations, and evaluated by the structural change in atomic scale. Shape memory effect is performed thermally in a temperature interval on cooling and heating. Also, superelasticity is also a result of the stress-induced materials transformation and performed with mechanical stressing and releasing in the elasticity limit at a constant temperature in the parent region. This is the temperature hysteresis of shape memory alloys on cooling and heating. On cooling, materials transformation start at MS temperature and completed at MF temperature. After that, on heating, reverse austenitic transformation start at AS temperature and completed at AF temperature. MS is martensit start at MF is finished temperature also. AS is austenitic start and AF is austenitic finished temperatures. This is a stress-strain characteristic in shape memory effect and superelasticity. As I stated, for the shape memory effect, material deformed in the low temperature condition. Also, as you can see, early stage of deformation exhibit elastic material behavior and stress-induced materials transformations occurred at the plateau level. For the superelasticity, stressing and releasing paths are different and hysteresis loss energy dissipation. Chapman's behavior is evaluated by the structural change in atomic scale by cause internal stress and shape change occur in the bulk level. Chapman's effect is governed by the crystallographic transformation, thermal and stress-induced vorticity transformation. Thermal-induced vorticity transformations occur on cooling with cooperative movements of atoms in one monotype direction on the one monotype planes of the parenthesis region, along with the lattice twinning reaction and ordered parenthesis structure turn into the twin vorticity structures. Twin structure also turn into the twin vorticity structures by means of stress-induced vorticity transformation with deformation material in the vorticity condition. Superelasticity is also governed by the stress-induced vorticity transformation and ordered parenthesis structures turn into the detivant vorticity structure with stressing. However, lattice twinning and detivant reactions play important role in the vorticity transformation and they are driving by the lattice invariant shear. This is the schematic of Chapman-Mery cycle in the crystallographic level. Let me inform you that Chapman-Mery effect and superelasticity is observed in the beta phi region of material and ordered parenthesis structure is essential for the quality of Chapman-Mery effect and superelasticity. First step is the cooling for Chapman-Mery effect and on cooling, ordered parenthesis structure turn into the twin vorticity structure by means of thermal-induced vorticity transformation. After that, with the deformation in the low temperature condition, twin vorticity structure turn into the detivant vorticity structures by means of stress-induced vorticity transformation. Following these treatments on cool heating, detivant structure turn into the ordered parenthesis structure. Then, after that, on crystallographic structure cycle between detivant vorticity structures and ordered parenthesis structures on cooling and heating in reversible way. This is important that this cycle is completed thermally for Chapman-Mery effect after first cooling and deformation processes. This is also a schematic of superelasticity. For the superelasticity, materials are stressed in elasticity limit in the parenthetic region and ordered parenthesis structure turn into the detivant vorticity structures by means of stress-induced vorticity transformation. After that, on releasing, detivant structure turn into the ordered parenthesis structures by means of reverse austenitic transformation. It is important that this cycle is completed mechanically for superelasticity. As I stated, superelasticity is also linked with stress-induced vorticity transformation, which is induced by applying only mechanical stress. And with this stress, parent austenitic phase structure turn into the completed detivant vorticity structure as in the deformation setup of Chapman-Mery effect and detivant vorticity structure turn into the parenthesis structure upon releasing. Also, crystal structure of the material cycle between detivant vorticity structures and ordered parenthesis structure on stressing and releasing. It is important that stress-strain curve exhibit nonlinear behavior. Stressing and releasing paths are different, and this hysteresis loss refers to the energy dissipation. This is the stressing and releasing path for Chapman-Mery effect in the stress-strain diagram. As you can see, stressing and releasing paths also are different, and also this diagram exhibits nonlinear behavior and hysteresis loss refers to the energy dissipation. Thermal-induced vorticity transformations are first-order solid-state phase transformations and mainly occur in the two-step in the beta phi region of the material. These are Bain distortion and lattice invariant shear. These are the basic beta phase structures in Chapman-Mery alloys. First figure represents the ordinary body-centric cubic structure. Second figure represents the Sodium chlorotide superlattice stresses thirdly represented the authority superlattice stresses mainly observed in the ternary copper-based yapmamalı algılar. Also, last figure represented L2-1 type crystal stresses in the yapmamalı algılar. Brain distortion is mainly affected in ternary copper-based yapmamalı algılar and consists of an expansion of 26% in the 101 type direction called brain axis and a compression of 11% in the 100 type direction perpendicular to the brain axis. There are three brain axes, these are cube axes, 10, 010, and 001, and BCC-based units that turn into the body-centered tetragonal structures, there are three variants with different orientations. That these invariants occur as martensit variant on 100 type planes of austenite matrix, which is basal plane of martensite, and that shares occurs in 100 type direction on the 100 type planes. 100 plane familiar represents 613 planes and totally 24 martensit variant occurs with the lattice invariant share. Lattice invariant share and lattice twinning is not uniform in copper-based yapmamalı algılar and that shares cause to the formation of layer stresses. 100 type planes of the parenthesis turn into the unusual layer structure which consists of an array of closed packet planes with complicated stacking sequences called as 3R, 9R or 18R martensite depending on the stacking sequences on the closed packet planes of the ordered lattices. The periodicity and therefore the unit cell is completed through 18 layer in directions that in case of 18R martensitic structures in ternary copper-based shape glomerulus. This is the formation of layer structure with lattice invariant shape. First figure represent the stacking of 100 type planes of austenitic matrix and with lattice invariant shape. This stacking turn into the layer structure with stacking sequences ABC, BCA, CAB, A and other for 18R martensitic structures. These are the basic terms and definition related to the shape memory effect and superelasticity. As you can see, experimental studies were performed on the copper-based shape memory algorithms. As you can see, alloy composition and decomposition were selected in the beta phase region of the material. Also, it is important that martensit start and finish temperatures are over the room temperature and both of the alloy samples are completely in the martensitic state at the room temperature. Specimens obtained from these alloys were solution treated for homogenation in the beta phase is as following, then quenched in ice grain and aged at room temperatures. These temperatures are 830 and 700 degrees for copper zinc aluminum and copper aluminum mangan alloy samples, and this temperature were selected in the beta phase region of the materials. Powder specimens for X-ray examination were prepared by filling the alloys and the specimens were sealed in evacuated groups and given the beta phase homogenization treatments in order to release the strain effect and other effects. These temperatures are also the same and homogenization time was selected 15 minutes for both of the alloy samples. Powder diffractorants were obtained for all the specimens at the different stage of aging in a long time interval. This is an X-ray diffractorant taken from copper zinc aluminum alloy samples after room time aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorant exhibits superlattice reflection. It is important that these plane pairs are important for ternary copper-based shape memory alloys. These are 122, 202, 128, 208, 110, 210, and others. This is also another diffractorant taken from copper aluminum mangan alloy samples after long-term aging at room temperature for about 15 years after quenching. As you can see, this diffractorant also exhibits superlattice reflection witness plain pairs. A series of X-ray diffractoron have been taken from both of the alloy samples. In a long time interval, and some change have been observed in the diffraction angles, peak intensities, and peak characteristic with aging duration. In particular, some of the successive peaks have shifted toward each other, and these peaks provide the following relation between Miller indices for 8NR Martens Lister structures. These plane pairs can be listed as follows for 8NR Martens Lister structures, as I stated on the diffractorons 1-2-2, 2-0-2, 1-2-8-2-0-8, 1-2-10-2-0-10, 0-4-3-2-0, and others. At the long-term investigation, it is observed that these peaks may come close to each other with aging duration, and these change reveal the changes in the crystal structure of the material. I will skip. Second experimental studies were performed on electron microscope, taken electron diffraction and image of surface and interface of the material. As you can see, electron diffraction patterns also exhibit superlattice reflection for both of the alloy samples. Conclusion. Shapemomer effect is evaluated by the structural change in microscopic scale by means of Martensitic transformation. The fundamental structures of the beta type martensites are orthorhombic closed packet structure, which consists of an array of closed packet plane in copper based Shapemomer alloys. The beta type martensites have the layer structures, and they are characterized by the stacking sequences on the order in the parenteral region. Copper-based ternary alloys have the duo-trio-type superlattice structure in the parenteral region, and the following stacking sequences occur with the martensit formation. The sequences are A, B, C, B, C, A, C, A, B, A, B, C, B, C, A, C, and A before 8NR martensitic structures. Based on the austenite-martensit relation, the basal plane of 9R or 8NR martensite originates from the monotype planes of the parentheses on which lattice invariances occur in the monotype direction during the martensitic transformation. These are the references, and thank you very much for your attention.